Hey everybody, this is Everest Paradox, and welcome back to the Fallout 4 PC modded Let's Play series, Shelter. So, I did do a couple of things off-screen to help the game play a little bit more smoothly. I changed the FOV for first person and third person. Now what that basically does is it gives it a wider viewing angle so I have a bit more information to work with, especially in combat. And also, some people have certain issues with particular FOVs where they will actually get motion sickness. So hopefully, any of you out there who have motion sickness issues, this will help you if you were having that particular issue. On top of that, I also did go back and make sure I had that mod I was describing installed, the Scrapworks, or it's actually Scrap Made rifle skin. So we're going to go ahead and equip. Let me go ahead and save this as well, because I'm probably going to need this at some point. I'm going to put this on that. Sadly, I don't have much ammo for this one, I don't think. Yeah. Alright. So let me go third person so I can show you this. Let's get some sunlight. Here we go. So if you look at the rifle, this is the Scrap Made new combat shotgun and rifle skins by, if I'm looking at this correctly, Millennia. So, and this is also available on the Nexus mods. If you look at the rifle itself, you see it's a bit more realistic, it's a bit more rusted, a bit more pitted. And if you actually look at the wood right below the sniper scope itself, it's a bit more weathered, a bit more realistic. Well, I just said realistic twice, but you get the general idea. It looks better. It looks like something you'd find in a post-apocalyptic world where people aren't necessarily doing weapon maintenance anymore because they don't really have the materials nor the resources to do so anymore. And that's for the rifle. Now, the shotgun is in a very similar matter. If you actually look at the barrel, it's kind of hard to tell because I can't get much closer, but there's pitting all up and down the right, all up and down the barrels of the shotgun now. And if you look up near the stock or the back area of the shotgun itself, where the hand, near where the hand is, you can see where it's worn in certain places that you would imagine would have wear and tear by use. Now, can I get him to lift this up right quick? And I'm gonna spin around. Now, if you look at the front of the shotgun, right underneath where his, right next to his hand, where the grip should be, they also improve the texture on that as well. But that's enough of going over that particular mod. Let's go ahead and get back to the exploration. We ran to our friend Sully here in the last episode. Isn't that a cow? Or a mutant deer? Something? Anyway. So we ran to our friend Sully.
Hey,
and we actually...
mean,
we messed with his computer.
Come on.
Straight away, sir.
And we found out that he's been excavating this old mining complex, but he's ran into an issue. There is something scratching from within inside the wall, and that has him concerned. I actually don't have much ammo on that one. Switch to the pistol.
I wonder how the quarry flooded.
Who knows, Codsworth. But the further down he went, the more sounds he's been hearing, and now he wants us to actually go into the water, which I'm not a huge fan of, but we do have some rataways, so we could do it.
Dug right into a spring.
And fix the valves or the whatever issue he's having. So, but first I'm going to steal all of his stuff. Because
nice.
If I'm going to be doing work for this guy, I'm going to be getting more than paid. Take everything that is not nailed down. Can't take that. What's this over here? Looks like this is an elevator shaft. We know, Codsworth. You wonder how the quarry flooded. Yeah, that's just an elevator. What's this? Cram, duct tape. Duct tape's always great in this game. And I think, is that it? Well, that's it for here, anyway. Is the elevator working? Okay, yeah, it's working. That's good. Alright. Looks like we have a locked something. Not that way. Probably need to turn down the sensitivity on my controller so I can do this a little bit more effectively. Now, I was talking about hacking last time, and I was actually thinking about just, there's a mod that you can install that makes hacking super easy, but I think I'm gonna stick it out and just try and hack when I can, when it's most convenient, and when it's most profitable for me to actually be doing so. I'm not going to enjoy this. Now, I know we have Rataway, which will help us with the rads we're going to end up getting from going in this water. I just hate wasting resources. Now, for any of you who have played previous Fallout titles, you will know that if you accrue too much rads, you'll actually start mutating, very in a similar fashion to how ghouls look when they mutate. Which, if you're going for a Let's Play where you don't care about mutation, that's fine. But it makes it more difficult to interact with certain people if you are mutated, because there are some superhumanists who think that anyone is mutated is just a monster. They don't care where you came from, they don't care where you're going. You're just a monster to them. Thankfully, you shouldn't have that issue. This should help our current issue. Let's get back to shore and put on some Rataway before I die. Get on shore. Right. Probably gonna end up using all of our Rataway just to do that. Now, you might say that that was kind of a waste of resources, and I agree, but this way we can go ahead and see what is so important about this mining complex that he would stay here this long. And plus, I'm playing on normal, so resources hopefully won't be that hard to come by. I remember in Fallout 3, things like Rataway were extremely hard to come by if you weren't playing a scavenging kind of build where you would find more resources because of the way you were kitted out, the way your perks were distributed. And this is certainly not going to be
there it is.
This is not going to be a scavenger playthrough.
Hey, so. That's a ticket. You do the honors. Hit that switch on the end of the pump.
I wonder how the quarry flooded.
Maybe they dug right into the spring.
Uh-oh.
Wait a second. Did you hear that?
Oh, shit. Crab people.
Let's do this.
Get up.
All right. Still in one.
Get him. Get him, Cotsworth. Shoot him in his stupid face. We gotta do this. Trying to go for a headshot. Mire lurks. Mutant crabs, which is funny because just considering where we are geologically in the United States, well, in the fake United States, something like this I don't think would necessarily exist. Unless there are, like, mud crabs, similar to how in Georgia we have, like, what's their name? Because we used to eat them. Well, I used to eat them. Well, no, we still do. Basically, crawdads. So, in Georgia we have crawdads, which are basically shelled critters like a crab, but not so much. They're basically shellfish, freshwater shellfish. And I don't think this far into West Virginia is it where we are? That sounds right, because we're heading to Concord. I don't honestly think that something like that would reasonably exist.
I guess I shouldn't be surprised that started up. Anyway, I still got some tinkering to do on this thing. It'd be too hard now, though. Thanks for pitching.
Maybe they dug right into
a little something before you clear out.
Give me my money. Cool. Plug in that hole. Well, we leveled up, so let's go ahead and go in that. Now, I was looking at the skill trees earlier, and apparently I can't get the next level of this unless I have agility 3 or higher. The thing is I have agility 3, but it still won't let me do it, so what I'm going to start doing is, this is also going to affect how many action points I have, so I can run faster, I can use VATS better, so I'm going to invest a little bit in this. But what I'm probably going to do is, after this, I'm going to invest a little bit in charisma so we can up the chances of getting those unique text availabilities. Level 4. Because that's going to play a huge role. If we're going to be playing a sneaky, stabby character, I want as many options available to me as possible to avoid open conflict with heavily armored thugs. Like, if we run into some not-so-friendly Brotherhood of Steel, or intelligent but aggressive super mutants, etc., etc. Picking all the flowers. Sleep on the mattress. Alright, where is our thing to conquer? Okay, that's our thing to conquer. So we're heading to the Jewel of the Commonwealth. I really love the way that they did, like, just randomly distributed stuff in this game. In Fallout 3, and to a significantly lesser extent in New Vegas, in Fallout 3, you had the wasteland, but it didn't feel as fleshed out. It didn't feel like a world where people used to live. Oh, shit. I don't think so. Get him, Codsworth. Toy hail. Oh, shit. Bug people. Acid-spewing bug fuckers. Now, I have to remember that as I'm picking up stuff, I can always give things to Codsworth. And he's... Okay, he wandered off for a second there. You had me concerned. Bottle cat, silver spoon. Now, ghouls in this game are significantly more... What's the word I'm looking for? They're very zombie-like. And I like that, because when you think of a ghoul, you think sort of the undead. What's cool about that is the fact that they move in such a jittering fashion that it's hard to...
Rubbish.
It's hard to, anticipate their actions. Anticipate what they're going to do. Okay, I gotta be careful, because I think that this train yard seems to have a lot more of them than I thought. Codsworth should be fine, but me, on the other hand, well... Oh shit, there are a lot of them. This will be fun. Kaboom. Kaboom. This is why I love sniper rifles. Until I miss.
It's a fight then!
Oh, shiitake mushroom. Oh, that's too bad. Baby rattle. That's just weird.
Hurry-ho!
She just ran right at me, didn't she? Another thing I like about the new ghouls is that they disintegrate, or they fall apart. Just lovely. Ghoul dance. I'm bad with this pistol though. I need to get better at that. Okay, he did. He did, so it don't matter. There's one more feral ghoul over there. But I love the way that they did the ghouls in this game. Much more... Thankfully, I have a lot of pistol ammo. Open that door just in case I need to make a quick escape. I don't appear to be in that huge of a threat. Which is to say, that's probably... part of the course for this early in the game, is you really shouldn't be running into a situation where you're going to end up dying a whole terribly lot. Ooh, I need bags of cement for later. Wow, Codsworth cleared this place out. Let's rob the joint. Ooh, lots of stuff. I like it. What's the computer have to say to me? View cargo manifests. Intake, drill parts, rebar, okay. Invoice, electrical wire. So this is basically a, it's a forward station. On the, I guess they were building up this area, or maybe this is just a way station for trains going through to a building up area, either within the Commonwealth or without. Okay, well, we're done here. Let's go to that building and see what it has to say for itself. Did we rob everyone? Well, we did now. Such a beautiful game. Let's see, if I remember correctly, is it pause? No, that's not it. Yeah, that's the Sweet Effects preset I have installed that's switching between versions. I'm trying to figure out which one I prefer. This one is a bit more bright, whereas this one is a bit more subdued. Sort of gives it that Wild West feel. Guess it doesn't really terribly matter that much. I kind of like the higher contrast on this one, though. But, you know, your opinions may vary. I love modding. I love modding so much. And if you all know of a mod that you want me to feature on the channel on this Let's Play, just let me know. Now, for obvious reasons, I'm not going to feature some of the more mature mods that I know exist, but there are certain mods that I will partake. And I wish we'd fought more raiders, because there's actually a gore mod or a blood mod that I wanted to show off. Critical failure in the track switch system has been detected. Please clear the track. Spotlight control. Admin connected to activate lights. So there's an issue somewhere on the track, which we might go investigate.
It's 5:30. She's late. No, something's wrong. Someone's coming. Look, 5 of them. It's a trap. Damn it, they've got us surrounded. What do we do?
We have been deceived, brother. We must fight for our right to party.
What? Dutchman, I...
The Dutchman?
There's no time. Good luck, A9.
A9?
10, 9, 8, 7.
No! He dead. He very dead.
No!
He ain't gonna make it.
No, I'm not going back. I can't. I won't.
Well, this is interesting. It almost sounds like they were like either spies or like secret agents. But I'm gonna hold on to that just in case. That's probably something that might come into play later in a future storyline. But so someone was killed. It's probably this guy. Another pipe pistol. Dutchman's instructions. Sorry about that, buddy. But I'm going to strip you of all of your stuff. All the stuff. Would it be in miscellaneous? Yeah, the Dutchman's instructions. Deliver your package to the old switching station. The runner arrives at midnight. If you need gear, look for the blue barrel. Ooh, so there's a stash of something somewhere. A blue barrel, huh? Blue barrel, blue barrel, blue barrel. Was there a blue barrel in this switch box? Or is this not even a switch box? No, this is like a watchtower. Sorry, I don't know train yards. That's not my bag. This reminds me, this whole broken highway thing reminds me of Darksiders, the first one. I loved, like, the post-apocalyptic landscape of that one. But there's a... Is this the switch station? It would almost have to be. And the blue barrel would have to... Well, That's a green box. That's not a blue barrel. Not a blue barrel, not a blue barrel, not a blue barrel. Now, the computer did mention that there was an issue at the switching station. So before we move on to Concord, we're going to look for said switch station. Well, let's verify before I go wandering off into the nonsense world. Is this a switch station? Rocco Industries Terminal Link. This seems more like an office. Because with a switch station, I would imagine that there would actually be, like, switch mechanisms to control the tracks. But I don't see anything. Unless this is it over here and that's all that's left. There's something all the way over there. What is that? Oh, that's a sign. Never mind. Not what we're looking for, but still interesting. Let's see what that is. Let's see, we've got the... Looks like a processing plant of some description. Oh, rain. So, cool. I get to show off another mod. Yeah. So, this, if it starts thundering and lightning as well, but, where is it? Where is it on my fun little list of cool things? And why is there a cow in this box? Buddy, you're kind of trapped, sorry to say. But where was I? I'm distracted easily. It is True Storms Wasteland Edition. It is a storm and weather overhaul, and this goes really well with the Darker Nights mod that I highlighted earlier. And as you can see, it's like, the funny thing is I haven't played so much of the base game, as I don't know if this is actually a real effect, but the fact that there's still sunlight pouring out through the clouds. No, that's not sunlight, that's the spotlight. Wow, I am stupid. That's the spotlights. What are the spotlights supposed to do exactly? Anywho, but yeah, real weather mod. Very cool, especially if we get some thunderstorms later, and we get to highlight the light effects that are involved with the mod itself. Really cool stuff. Really nice, in-depth little mod. And plus I have I think I have True Fog installed as well, so yeah, like, we have a bit of fog going on, which is really nice. But when it gets really, really bad, we'll really be able to highlight how just good this mod makes weather. Where is the switching station? What am I missing? This is so weird. Ooh, you're problematic. Yeah, he's a wild dog. Which is interesting. That, well, they're radioactive. So that makes a little bit of sense, but... But wild dogs in this kind of a, you know, post-apocalyptic humanity is not necessarily the most prominent species kind of setting. You'd find a whole lot more wild dog packs. They would actually form groups to survive. Smaller dogs being the first to be actually eaten by the bigger dogs. And you find a lot of this in lesser developed or like more... less... What's the word I'm looking for? It's not lesser developed, it's like less population controlled as far as animal countries, where they basically just, they don't monitor the population of the animals themselves. Is this a switch station? No, this looks like another gas station. You will find roving packs of dogs. Most of the time, they won't bother humans because they're still aware that humans... Ooh, balls. Okay, I'm better. I'm kind of better. But, I'm gonna be a bit more cautious this time. But as I was saying, they will only attack as a pack format. Really? Well, there went my arms. Nah. I should have saved. I have no idea where I am right now. Well, that was disappointing. Well, first death, so that's kind of nice. But yeah, like I was saying, roving dog packs. I know when I was overseas, the roving dogs were around. They weren't so much an issue, but you'd always hear them at night. Because they would actually fight each other. The packs would fight each other. And I'm all the way back here. Crap. I wish there was a way to, like, auto-save after certain events, but that's fine. I mean, we know where we're going, we know how many enemies we're going to be dealing with, so we'll just make a quick run to the places we need to go, kill everything, and then move on. That might be the, that's pretty cool. The limit of what we can do for the moment. But I'm surprised that we didn't run into that switch station. Because this can't be the switch station, because there are no physical controls.
Hurry-ho!
Well, good news. I just still have rifle ammo now. Well, I broke something. I'm really bad with this pistol. In the head. In the box. Alright, steal. Everything. I need that concrete for later, and you will see why in the future. Got some more rat away. Good, good, good. We need to head to Concord anyway, so I guess this isn't too terribly large a loss, but we are going to take that evidence tape.
200 years ago, I never would have thought this level of dust possible.
Well, it's a thing. It's a thing, Cosworth. I didn't get that pack of cigarettes earlier. Take all of that. Door. Ooh, I didn't get the duct tape earlier either. You see the things you find whenever you actually go back and explore an area. And all of this is going to help us significantly later. When we start building up locations. Did I level up earlier? Oh, shit. There's still one more room somewhere. You're good, Cosmo. You're all kinds of fun. Let's go to this building. Steal all their stuff and take that tape, and then we'll save this time. Take the pipe pistol. Pipe rifle, I should say. All this and that.
It's half past. She's late.
Crap, do I have to listen to most of this?
No.
Okay, I don't. Because we know what's going on. And plus, I think we can listen to that later in our box. Spotlight control. Activate. System diagnostic. System diagnostic, two spotlights linked, distance, no intruders detected, But it's making mention that there's a critical system failure in the track switching system. Please clear. Does it just mean that these broken down train parts are... is it just referencing that there's something blocking the track? Because if so, then I've been wasting my time. Alright, well, let's keep heading this way. Oh, I almost forgot to save. Alright.
That makes...
Okay. Sorry, I had to check the time. It's almost time for food time. Because I'm hungry. Oh, another one of these shacks. With a mannequin. Which is, in and of itself, a bit creepy. I hear gunfire. Oh shit, Brad's. What the fuck? I don't have anything that can protect me from rads either. Oh, it's... what? Okay, let's go and explore what's causing this ruckus first, then, I suppose.
I had no choice. What the?
Whoa. Mole rats. I got your back.
Sir, something's afoot.
Yeah, mole rats.
God, I saw something.
Yeah, mole rats.
I was just getting warmed up.
Spiker Cam is paying off.
She's not bad.
Caution, sir. I do believe something is not shit time.
Bitch.
Like a little dust up to get the oil.
Well, that could have gone better. Is she dead? I don't see her. That doesn't necessarily mean she's dead, but I don't see her. Lady. Where did you go, lady? She just like bail? She must have. Well, that's unfortunate. You can do certain events where you like save people. Oh, there she is. Hi.
Hey there.
Thanks for the help.
Yay, money. Well, bottle caps, but same general idea. Codsworth like that. Oh, that's right. They have a they react to that. Bitch. I hope not. I hate these things. I actually kind of hate these things more than rat roaches. Duct tape. All kinds of fun stuff. Okay, Codsworth,
hey.
I need to talk to you.
Mr. Nicholas.
Wait there.
Here's what I have.
And I need to go to my inventory. And you need to take... everything that does not seem... They need to make a mod for this so that you can just tell him to keep all the junk. Ooh. Comfort grip calibrated pipe pistol. I might have to play with that. Cram, desk lamp, fork, dry water, duct tape, extinguishers... hold on to the eyeglasses, because I think that's funny. Flip lighter, holding on to the grenades. Gas canister. Sorry, I'm wasting a little bit of time, but I'm trying to get all this stuff out of my inventory before that becomes an issue. High capacity pipe rifle. That's nice. That's pretty neat, actually. Kickball, leather chest piece, leather armor. I haven't listened to that, have I? I don't think I have. Molotov cocktails, ooh, Nuka-Cola bottles, pack of cigarettes, two paintbrushes, pencils, rifle, pistol, plastic bowl, pork and beans, psycho, water, keeping the rat away, definitely all the rat roach meat, screwdrivers, shadeless lamp, oh, Codsworth can't carry anymore. Actually a first for me. I've never actually maxed out a follower yet. Okay, well, let's keep moving forward, I suppose. Where? Oh, where? Okay, the death gas station was this way. Yeah, because it was in the same direction as the refining facility. Or at least what I assume is a refining facility. that I will save before I do anything at that gas station again, lest I get myself killed. Okay, yeah, we're right about back where we were. A little bit of a detour, but nah. It is what it is. Oop, doggy.
What's all this?
Yeah, you don't get to touch me, mongrel. Looks like weather is about to roll in too. Ah, there's the rain. I love rain. I love rain. Okay. That looks like a small town. Oh, there's the gas station thing. I think. Oop. There's a couple things, actually. Starlight Drive-In. So, let's go ahead and save. Before we do anything else. Alright, I gotta be a little bit more cautious this time. Got a cooking station. Radroach meat and a machete. Well, either there is a family here or this is extremely creepy. Take all the food. It's funny, I'm like the worst kind of person in this game, because I just take all of their stuff.
Empty, eh?
For a moment.
Just look at the state of this place.
Shit. There's two bombs there, too. Two landmines. Or there were.
It looks like a movie was showing when the bombs fell.
Oil cans, adjustable wrench, tin can. Now, someone has clearly built this area up, but I don't know why. And that bothers me a lot. Duct tape. This would be a great area to sort of build up as a defensive position. Or at least as a forward outpost. God, if this game had multiplayer, good lord. That would be just glorious. Pompadour. It's funny, wearing the pompadour wig actually increases your charisma. Which, given the time frame that this game is supposed to take place, and it's not terribly surprising. Is there anyone down there? There's a box of something. I've got 12 rounds. Neat. Yeah, just look at the weather effect. Oh, lightning. It's not a bad storm, so it's kind of hard to tell where the lightning's going to come from. Alright, well, we took some damage, so let's go ahead and save, because I don't know how much more... Oh, of course. Of course. Ooh, rabbit. Mole rat. Wabbit mole rat. Not a rabbit, a rabbit. Shit, rads. So I probably shouldn't be close to the vehicles. Just in case the vehicles themselves are sort of retaining the leftover radiation from the bomb fall, which is possible. Okay, we know there are explosives in this area. Why can't I see them? There is something clearly there. It's a trap. We might not be able to just generally avoid the traps by not going into the obvious area. Kyle, are we fighting something? Maybe. I guess not. I guess we will have to go into the building to get what we truly want. Or just be self-aware and don't get blown up by explosives. Well, this guy didn't make it. Hey, buddy. Sorry about your loss. Well, the rat roaches, or the mole rats, are still here, clearly. Ooh, umbrella.
And now,
old fire extinguisher.
From our sponsors. Why drink dirty radioactive water when you could have it pure and bottled? Check Kowalski's clean water.
Where is this bomb?
Keep a knockin' by
shotgun round, looks like. Bye. Maybe if I can sort of force out the explosive, like force it to detonate. I can't see it for whatever reason. Nuka-Cola Cherry. Ooh. I will take that bottle cap mine. That's pretty vicious, actually. Gun drops. Okay, looks like we've cleared out this area. And before we move on, I'm thinking to call the episode here. So this has been Fallout Shelter, the modded Let's Play series. If you like the video, please... please thumb up this video. Yeah. Words. I can't find them. Comment in the comment section below. Share, subscribe, follow me on social media. And as always, I will see you in the next part. Bye-bye!